Yeah, he pitched out of trouble, and it was one of those days that you could tell the ball was taking off on him a little bit, kind of trying to find that grip. Two balls sailing inside, kind of that cool, dry air. But also, he had enough kind of grip to really make the ball move, too. So I think he found a nice feel with his sinker, but I thought he did a nice job with everything. He just made better pitches when he had to.
Did you have to kind of dial that in like midway through the start there, just get a feel for where the movement was going? So
I think it was truly this getting a grip on the ball that was kind of getting in the way when you'd see him run deep counts. It was frustrating. He was trying to get a little sweat going to where he could use that to help him, but it was just one of those nights early in the season that happened. But then I think he got on side a little bit. There was a great trip out to the mound by Derek Lilliquist to kind of get him on top of the ball a little more. He was starting to run side to side a little bit. But overall, he was putting it where he wanted to and got the ball on the bottom and letting guys make plays.
Diaz, four hits, three. Last game, do you see his swing coming around?
Yeah, he's in a good place. He's putting better at bats. You can see he's seeing the ball where he's trusting it, where it's not like we talked about Dex early in the season, just couldn't wait to get up there and hit it because it's the first one he saw. I felt like it was his only chance, but he's tracking the ball well. He's taking walks. He's laying off tough pitches and getting balls that he can drive.
Do you think there's any correlation to you moving him down in the lineup and two good games, Diaz?
We never rule out anything. But you could see him starting to head in a little better direction even when we made that move. He certainly looks good now, and he's in situations where he can drive in runs too, and he's making the most of those. So, no reason necessarily put all the blame or credit whenever a guy's in a certain spot in the lineup. But when something looks right, try and stick with it if we can. I mean, we talked about that with Colton. And all of a sudden, we need to put him in another spot. And he did a nice job at the top of the lineup for us tonight.
Is Chad's hand okay?
Yeah, he is. He was sore at the end, being his throwing hand. It was one we just wanted to kind of get ahead of and let him get in here and get it worked on a little bit so we could have him tomorrow.
Do you think that it just, by moving a guy in the lineup, specifically Diaz out of that, just kind of alleviates maybe what he's trying to do or gives him a different look, like with RBI guy?
It can, but I think what we're seeing is a guy seeing the ball. You don't see the ball better in the sixth spot than you do in the two. There's times you put him in a certain spot in the order, and they may get pitched differently, which could be an advantage to him. But, I just don't really see that right now. Just trying to give him, something different, help him kind of, and that's usually what it is. It's not a reward and punishment thing. It's more of, where can we put a guy to, maybe change it up a little for him. And maybe he does see something different, or maybe he thinks a little different. You just don't know completely how that always registers with guys. But if it works, then you're happy for him.